It was almost showtime, and I can't find my other boots. What's a circus without a ringmaster? What's a ringmaster without his boots? But don't worry, things always work out by showtime. It's just that in the intro, we want everything to be just right. After all, we've gone through a lot of effort to bring you one of North America's largest miniature attractions. But it also took imagination. And that's the kind of stuff that makes miniature world so fantastic. Everything has to be just right. So while I find my boot, why not take a look at the greatest little show on earth? Ladies and gentlemen, Miniature World.
Coast is alive with some of nature's great panoramas. On the southern tip is Victoria, the seat of government for British Columbia. Victoria carries a British tradition and charm her namesake would be proud of. It's also part of the charm of Miniature World. The elegant Empress Hotel on Victoria's beautiful air has been home to this remarkable attraction since 1970. Here the panoramas are on a different scale, but just as alive. In 9 enchanting worlds of history and wonder. George Devlin created Miniature World with 12 dioramas that have now grown to over 50 intricately detailed creations. George sought to explore his own creativity and hit upon a theme with universal appeal, a fascination with miniatures shared by young and old alike. It's a fascination that requires precision, time-consuming care, and much attention. George Devlin combines that attention to detail with creativity to produce a most memorable display. Before becoming a replay of history or a fantasy scene, it all starts as details on paper. Ideas are brought together from historical accounts, photographs, and sketches, then discussed by the design team. As the concept evolves, further sketches are worked up to help visualize and plan the scenes. Once the refined sketches are approved, blueprints are drawn up, and the construction begins. From concept to construction, many months may pass, and that time and research all pays off when you take a closer look. The first world you enter is out of this world. Set your clock ahead and welcome to our virtual future of Space 2201. Inventive model work and blacklight effects create a unique sensation. You find yourself aboard the latest Tracker-class star cruiser, Avian 1, somewhere between Mars and Jupiter. Check outside to get your bearings. Oh yes, on the port side, we're in orbit over Jupiter. There's the Antigua 75 space station. The space station is primarily research-oriented and a way station for those seeking to time travel. Its population varies between 7,000 and 10,000 professional and maintenance personnel. With the exception of periodic shipments of specialty foods, nitrogen pellets, and technological upgrades, the station is approximately 85% self-sufficient. Take a look at the many craft touring the vicinity. Either jaunt to nearby moons Europa or Callisto, or perhaps a routine maintenance trip to repair the Magnusol collectors. The Antigua 75 space station is a hub of extraterrestrial activity. Those wishing to take up residence within the space station need to pass extensive physical fitness requirements and better bone up on their education in virtual systems and fractal thermodynamics. Into deep space, you can see the Brunelli Eye, a previously unknown phenomenon of nature discovered in the year 2152 by R.U. Brunelli. The Brunelli Eye is a space-time corridor into entirely different locations of the universe. Essentially, the Brunelli Eye responds to thought patterns, a stable means of thinking your way to wherever you can imagine, opening up infinite possibilities for exploration of both the known and the unknown universe. To prevent misdirection or mishaps, missions and tours have only been sent through the Brunelli Eye with crew and passengers under the safety of sedation with a singly trained conscious navigator. These navigators can take their passengers safely through the eye and back with virtually no time or space distortion. Our miniature outer space journey takes us through the Brunelli Eye to a far corner of the universe on the fringe of the Milky Way galaxy. Just outside, you'll see we've arrived at a mining base. The practical world of science, business, and commerce quickly realized the new potential of galaxy-wide space travel. A corporate presence has been made right here among a unique cluster of asteroids. The Asteroidal Mining Corporation has set up shop in this sector at the Hercursus Taro 5 mining base. What is mined in the far reaches of our galaxy is a new substance, similar to platinum and gold, and yet hard as diamond, and given the name Elementum KRC. What is remarkable is that Elementum KRC was found to be edible when dissolved in a solution of diethylamide. The byproduct of this process leaves a residue that the body readily assimilates, resulting in a turning back of one's biological clock, so that life is extended by hundreds of years. Of course, the Hercursus Taro 5 asteroidal mining base offers daily tours of their operation. All work and no play is not the future way. For a break in the routine of the 23rd century, how about a come-to-life computer-fabricated resort based on fractal dynamics? Well, welcome then to the Vesuvius D-Zone. The artist Orion was one of the first to dream up novel locations that are brought to life by traveling through the Grinnelli Eye. The Vesuvius D-Zone was conjured up and modified as a resort overlooking three carbon stars. Visitors are protected from the harsh gravitational and electromagnetic influences of the stars by the mathematical field generated by the fractal D-Zone. What it all means is that visitors have a wonderful and secure vantage point to view the Grinnelli Eye phenomenon as it weaves its way through three sectors of carbon star activity. Enjoy the fractal cliffs, a favorite to people from all walks of life, especially among stellar mathematicians looking for a unique diversion. Also provided are recreational tennis and golf courses, with a unique twist on the games. The balls used in these games are actually neutrino stars, which would have a weight on Earth of some 10 to the 12th power tons. Of course, under Vesuvian laws of physics, they're harmless spheres, which respond in quite a unique fashion when hit. A must for anyone looking for a game with a real warp drive. The shuttle has returned to Earth. Your journey into space 2201 has ended. But instead of returning to the present, step back into the past and more of the remarkable work of Miniature World's model makers. In the Enchanted Valley of the Castles, 12 of Europe's most famous castles are featured in a tranquil river valley setting. Originally designed to defend against attack in the Middle Ages, castles were built high and massive and provided a view over their inhabitants' domain. Today, many have been restored and returned to their original awe-inspiring splendor. These castles often house incredible collections of treasures, rare tapestries, and artifacts of ages past, and are maintained as tourist attractions. Traveling the valley are three railroads, and to reach the highest peaks are gondola ferries castle visitors. Massive stone walls and towers, wondrous architecture, colorful banners, each of the castles offers its own distinct beauty and style.
The fields of glory depict the pageantry of history through the ages. Here, some of man's finest and most courageous moments are recreated. In the 13th century, the White Rose of York and the Red Rose of Lancaster fought for the crown of England in the War of the Roses. The 40-year struggle of armor and steel ended with the death of Richard III and Henry VII ascending to the throne, so ending the Middle Ages. The American Civil War pitted brother against brother in one of the saddest of all wars. The Battle of Bull Run is epically recreated with panoramic effect. Although awed by the collector's pieces and the miniature work of the craftsman, one cannot help but reflect on the senseless devastation of human conflict throughout our history. Frontierland takes us to a time in our near past where our land was new and the struggle was against nature. The Haida people of the Pacific Northwest have a rich culture, centuries old. This peaceful village scene reflects the first meetings with European explorers, notably Captain James Cook. Research at Miniature World may mean just taking a look at our local heritage buildings. Historic St. Mary's Church, still standing today, is modeled in miniature to exacting detail. Occasionally, historical accuracy gives way to the model maker's fancy. Not many of us have had a chance to see what Santa's workshop really looks like, but you can bet that Santa would appreciate this special place. Jonathan Swift's Gulliver's Travels inspired this view of Lilliput. Who would have believed such a story could become so real? The famous stories by Charles Dickens come alive in several scenes, bringing some of literature's favorite characters to life. Fagin, the Artful Dodger, and Oliver Twist, all in a glimpse of 19th century London, England. Visual accuracy is one thing, but mechanical accuracy? An intricate working model that performs as well as its full-size counterpart? Well, that's the Little Mills Lumber Company, a British Columbia sawmill scaled 1 inch to the foot. The mill performs all the functions of a real mill, processing miniature cedar logs into freshly lumbered planks. A film presentation takes you through each step of the process. Every lever, belt, and wheel pieced together like the real ones. It's astonishing, it's amazing, and it's what Miniature World is all about. Thorough planning and research that result in a version of reality or fantasy that is pure magic. Built into many of the displays at Miniature World are points of people participation, places where visitors can push a button to illuminate a point of interest or animate a display. Here's the buffalo hunt of the North American Plains Indians. Activate the trolley in the Toronto, Ontario of 1915. These are just a few of the many special effects designed to enchant and delight kids of all ages. The Great Canadian Railway exhibit is a reproduction of the building of Canada's Transcontinental Railway. This railway was the single greatest reason that Canada came into existence over 100 years ago. Working trains cross this great land coast to coast in an epic display more than 100 feet long. Effects include a special night and day illumination sequence. Careful synchronization is required. Two train lines are used to handle the mountain grades as well as show the spiral tunnel. But perhaps the greatest special effect is that of the Canadian landscape coming alive. Thousands of tiny fir and cedar trees patiently assembled. The convincing wheat fields of the prairies. All as if seen from an aircraft high above. Most special is the effect of actually stepping into history, taking part in the fantasy, drawing you further into the magic of the land of the small. Particular attention has been paid to the type of motors driving the effects, the power sources for the animations and working lights. These units will be on the go many hours a day, year-round, and must be reliable. So every working street light, spotlight, car headlight, and working mechanical piece is meticulously attended to, creating amazing reality in miniature. Making it real is the true challenge of these artists. It's the painstaking detail, the time-consuming, careful work that goes into each piece which makes these displays so captivating. The painting, every wheel, each chassis, all the faces, shirts, dresses, and shoes on thousands of characters. Making the trees green and the earth brown. The major displays may involve years of concept development and planning, then another year of construction and model building before opening to the public. The artist's dedication is pivotal to the success of each and every display. Dedication is readily apparent on taking a close look at Terra, a recreation of the Southern Mansion in the classic film Gone with the Wind. This miniature mansion used conventional building techniques, from cement foundation to specially cut floor joists, studs, and rafters. about 10,000 tiny cedar shingles were cut for the roof. Peeking through the windows brings more of the remarkable detail. There are three fireplaces created from over 6,000 hand-cast bricks, and they all really work. The rooms are fashioned after styles of the 1880s. Fine lace upholstered chairs, mahogany beds. The detail is stunning. All the dollhouse creations offer exquisite detail. A banquet feast fit for a king, served in an elegant dining room with all the trimmings, or tiny wine bottles in the butler's cellar. It's styled after Queen Mary's famous dollhouse now in Windsor Castle Museum. But it's not only the physical details that make it work. The individual events, the visionettes captured in each scene are also essential. In old London town, circa 1670, we see a barmaid luring customers into a tavern. A gentleman chases a youthful apprentice who's stolen his watch. Minstrels perform on the street for coins. These human situations, slices of life we can relate to, add wonderment and emotion throughout miniature world. We're drawn to the marvel of the work by skilled artists, but as well, the drama of the realities created. Of over 10,000 are presented to you in our spectacular The Wonderful World of the Circus. We first meet the circus at their winter headquarters, Sarasota, Florida, USA. The time is somewhere in the 1940s, the heyday of the large touring circus. In the mild Florida climate, performers, trainers, and animals use the time to relax from the weary grind of the circus tour. In the shops, new wagons were built with elaborate and ornate wood carvings. Built to last, they were called Rocks of Gibraltar on Wheels. At winter headquarters, new acts are prepared and the animals arrested before the new tour starts again in the spring. Don't worry, though, there is still time for the elephants to have fun outside. Public tours of the winter headquarters were always an adventure. Around every corner, there was something new and fantastic to see. The menagerie building was home to all the wild and exotic animals of the circus. By spring, the performers were relaxed and the animals rehearsed. It was all aboard for the new circus season. The pastoral countryside is quiet and peaceful as the heartland of the country awakens to spring. In the distance, the trained circus horn announces its arrival, and the peace breaks into excitement and anticipation. Traveling across the land, the circus train used up to 100 rail cars to carry all the equipment, animals, and people for their extravaganza. From town to town, the sight of that long circus train would almost be too thrilling to take. Even as the circus arrived, the day's work had to be completed. In the mine, the anticipation is for valuable ores, but only till the end of your shift, when you can again join your family and head out for the arrival of the circus train. The circus finally arrives on the outskirts of town. At the train yards, people, equipment, and animals are unloaded. The fancy wagons are prepared for the grand entrance into town. Main Street, here we come. In the first half of this century, the best advertisement for the circus was a spectacular parade. The colorful collection of animals, wagons, and costumes were marshaled through the city to announce the arrival of the greatest show on earth. The streets would be lined with people waving and enjoying the event. Balconies would be crowded by family and friends watching in wonder. As you experience this recreation, can't you imagine the thrill of a circus parade making its way down your town's main street? However, in a big city, not everyone makes it to the parade. There's always something else going on. Bustle of the city continues throughout the day and into the night, presented here with dramatic effect. Just beyond the city limits, on the other side of town, is the peace and tranquility of the city park. But beyond that, the Circus Big Top. Before lining up for the big show, you might try a visit to the wild animal tent. Or catch a sideshow where you might find the fantastic or the far-fetched. It pays your money, it takes your chances. On the showgrounds, the sights, smells, and sounds are simply too delightful to resist. It was hard to believe there was more under the big top, but there was. Strike up the band, cue the ringmaster. It's time for the greatest little show on earth. Three rings of laughs, thrills, and chills. It's all part of the fun of the circus. From the big top, we move over to the midway. Grab some cotton candy, try your aim at a shooting gallery, or hang onto your hat on a tilt-a-whirl. It's all brought to life here with amazing animated miniatures. The motion and color of the midway is truly exciting. For something a little wilder, how about the Wild West Show, a popular entertainment feature from the late 1880s to the 1920s. The adventure and spirit of pioneers from the Old West has a mighty strong appeal, especially with the added feature of genuine all-American heroes like Buffalo Bill. His show would feature trick riders galloping around, sharpshooters like Annie Oakley showing off their abilities, bandits would rob a stagecoach, and the grand finale was usually an action-packed cowboy and Indian battle. Just as all seems lost, to the rescue came the cavalry, quashing the siege and bringing justice to all. It's a rip-roaring, glorified view of the American West. Just past the showgrounds, the industrial park, home to established as well as new industry, continuing the vital cycle of economic growth. Ladies and gentlemen, the wonderful world of the circus. Just part of the wonders to be found here at Miniature World. Skilled artists working with collector's pieces and imagination to bring you into the world of the small. An eagle's eye view of history, of fantasy, a world of wonder and fascination. Ladies and gentlemen, Miniature World. It's the greatest little show on earth.